Hello everyone, I'm Kristen Oakes White. Thank you for joining us for This Week in Louisiana Agriculture, the only TV show bringing Louisiana farmers and consumers together every week. My partner Avery Davidson is out this week. Well, this past week, the Trump administration announced $200 billion in additional tariffs on Chinese goods. The Chinese government has responded by levying $60 billion more in tariffs on products ranging from meats to chemicals and machinery. While they did not add more to grains such as soybeans, as Twyla's Neil Melançon tells us, the damage has already been done.
The latest round of tariffs on $60 billion worth of goods wasn't good news for Louisiana farmers. While it didn't put any more onto soybeans, it did cause soybean prices to go lower, based on the fear that there would not be an end to this trade dispute anytime soon. Prices have come down this year more than $2 for beans and will likely stay that way, according to Greg Fox, a grain marketing specialist with the Louisiana Farm Bureau.
Well, it does feel like the markets are going to stay in that 830 to 850 range until we get a little bit more negotiations or a little bit more news out of the China talks. We're looking at negative 30s at some elevators, negative 20, negative 50. The biggest problem with the basis, that comes from the barge market.
The barge basis is the price for using barges on the Mississippi River. Usually for Louisiana farmers, it's positive, meaning they get paid extra because barges don't have to travel as far upriver. Right now, though, those barges aren't going anywhere, and farmers have to pay extra to move them. Worse, grain is stockpiling from other areas.
The other factor that we haven't seen in years is the Pacific Northwest is not loading out to China. So the rail that would go to the Pacific Northwest, that old crop has come to the Gulf. So that added to this negative basis because you just have more grain to pull from.
Fox says if this dispute with China changed tomorrow, we would still have the same barge situation this year.
I do believe if the tariffs were solved, I think this market could easily run back up to 10, but it's not going to fix the basis. Our basis is still going to be at a negative level until we can chew up those barges in the rail that's sitting out there now. And again, another problem with the basis, you're going to start to see new crop Midwest grain come down river. That's just going to add to the already stagnant barge market.
If there is one positive out of this, Fox sees, it's that American grain might get shipped to South America. Countries there will either use the grain internally or act as a reseller for China.
Earlier in the year, we did see where we made some sales into Argentina. Depending on what Brazil's sales are and Argentina's needs, we could see where we pick up some more of that South American export business.
Now, while both sides have said they are willing to come to the negotiating table, for the moment, there's no end in sight. We'll keep you posted with any new developments on our website. And Kristen, of course, this thing just doesn't have any end in sight. We've seen so many times where they've gotten close, but you know, one side or the other doesn't back down. And a lot of this has to do with Chinese intellectual property. They are taking American intellectual property for their own and making goods. And so I think that's really the sticking point. But in the meantime, I'm sure as you've seen, soybean prices have just suffered. And we've almost got a logjam now of barges on the Mississippi River. Greg Fox told me earlier today that they're even seeing some backup in Memphis and other areas. So it just isn't going to be good this year for soybean farmers, at least.
Well, that I know, and not news I wanted to hear, but I will tell you, I know that a lot of farmers are looking to the bailout, so to speak, the money, that and then thinking that that's going to help a lot. But if the tariff problem doesn't get resolved, this is really just a Band-Aid on a broken ankle, as they've been saying.
So. Right, and what about next year?
I mean, exactly.
That's the big thing. Are they going to pony up that much money next year? So, you know, what farmers really want is that open trade so they can, you know, have those markets to sell their crops into.
Exactly. Well, thank you for bringing us up to speed on an important issue, Neil Melançon.